Hello everyone, in this tutorial I am going to make a 2 gears simulation. For this I have made a base and a sketch of a rectangle 170 by 80, and I have extruded with 20 millimeter thick, and then I have drawn 2 circles with diameter 20 each, one in at the center of a coordinate system and the other 70 millimeter distance, and I have extruded with 50 millimeter extrusion length. Then I have made a gear, and for this I have made 2 circles, one with diameter 60 and the other one with diameter 20, and I have extruded with 20 millimeter extrusion length, and then I have sketched a profile. I have project that circle, that arc, and I have offset it with 10 millimeter, and then I have drawn a line and offset it 5 from to both sides and 10 from both sides, and I have trimmed and I have connected the endpoints to each other, and I have made a 5 millimeter and 10 millimeter in the upper 5 millimeter in upper edge and 10 millimeter in lower edge, and I have exit the sketch, and then I have extruded with 20 millimeter, and then I have made a circular pattern with 12 items and 30 degrees between each items. Now I am going to select start mechanical design assembly, and I am going to right click on product and use components, existing component, and I am going to select the base UCO. It's okay, and then again right click on products and select components, existing components, and bring the open the gear. As you see, gear is sitting tight. I am going to select the manipulation palette and X direction translate and select that one and move UCO, and I am going to make a coincident constraint between the base and the gear, and it is not fully constrained. I select the offset icon, select that face to that face, and make the distance 0. OK. Now you can select the update, and it's sitting on this on this I am going to right click on product and component, existing component, gear again, open. It is sitting there, close. And I am going to make a coincident constraint between this one and this one, and the offset between this face and this face is zero. Uko update. Now they are sitting as we this we will, but as you see those two crashing each other. I am going to select the manipulation palette, and I am going to select the rotate surround an axis, and I am going to select that axis, and I am going select that axis, and I'm going to select that gear and rotate. I am going to use the front view. As you see, it is good. Or you can draw a little more bit. Now it is okay. Uko. Now the assembly is complete. I am going under start, digital mock-up, DMU cinematic, and I am going to go to gear joint. I am going to use new mechanism, UCO, and the revolute joint 1, create between that one and that one, and the plane, base plane and gear plane, and make it angle driven. Okay, offset is zero, select UCO, and make angle driven for revolute 1, and revolute joint 2, create, and we are going to select that one, and that one, and the plane, that one, and that one, and it is okay. And we select in opposite direction, because when it's rotate clockwise, the other rotate counterclockwise, and it is okay. Now it is okay, and I am deleting those offsets. Delete, and I am going to see if the demolition, it cannot be on, because I need a fixed part. I am going to select the fixed part, and I am going to select the base. Now the mechanism can be simulated. I am going to select the simulation, and it is the minus 360 to 360. I am going to cancel it. I am going under application mechanism joints gear definition, And here, the angel driven, the lower limit is -360. I change it to 0, and the upper limit is 360. Uko. Now I am going to simulate when it is from 0 till 360, and I am going to draw the angels and use insert here, repeat, and change it to 0.04 and use it, and it's going fast. You can change it to slower that you can see it better how it rotates. Okay, it was all in this tutorial. See you on next tutorial.